Hello and welcome to Newsclick. Today are the times when the education sector is in crisis in India. While the HRD ministry is trying to saffronize education, there are states like Maharashtra where the Mughals have been completely deleted from history. Rajasthan is trying to build a wrong narrative about histories and wars. We have with us Manish Sisodia, the Deputy Chief Minister of Delhi and Education Minister, who has a dream of building a new education system in India. He calls it Delhi's education dream. So, sir, what is central to your dream in this system?
I don't have an education dream. I have a dream for my society, my country. And I see education is the only platform from which it can be fulfilled. So I never think what kind of education I'm looking for in my country. I always look for what kind of society, what kind of evolution, what kind of country I want. And I see education is the only way to shape that country. So then I come to education. Governance can't change the country. Governance can only govern the country the way it is. It can facilitate for fields like health, education system. So when I talk about education, my only thing is that I want a country where the society is just, where society is getting equal opportunities to be wise enough, equal opportunity to be skilled enough. And here we come for education. When we say education is the solution can never be good education for 20% people and bad education or rotten education system for 80% of the people. So in Delhi, my focus have been to fix that problem. Every child living in Delhi should have access to quality education. Every means, when I say every, it means every. 100%. The last child for whom the system thinks that, okay, this is from that society, this is the first generation learner, or maybe sometimes people say this is from the specially abled category. No, I'm saying every child means every child.
Okay, so everyone getting quality education is the prime focus
of your policy. Is the prime focus. So best of the best, so I'm working on it. I'm giving solutions to this. And my solution to quality education, or when you say dream Delhi education, is threefold. One is quality infrastructure for government schools, which I am glad to say that I'm not saying everything is solved, but we have started delivering on that front. We have built schools which are many times better than the best private schools. Not all, but many of them have become, and we are evolving with that. Then second is teachers training. I'm providing quality teacher training for my school teachers, government school teachers. I'm sending them to Cambridge, I'm sending them to Finland, Singapore, Germany, Russia, everywhere, wherever we hear of good education systems or practices, we send them. Basic principle of this second component is, if I want my students to get quality education, world-class education, I have to provide world-class understanding to my teachers. For world-class education, I need world exposure to my teachers, that I'm giving. So one is infrastructure, second is quality training for teachers, and third is the main content, that is teaching, learning, and learning abilities, evaluation. That's very dangerous. That's the core of the education. We see in many countries, education is activity oriented. We see in many countries, education has fixed the targets. Here in India, we don't. Education is not empowered enough, or maybe capable enough, to spark a dream in one's mind.
Okay, in that line, you know, you said 10,000 classrooms, 400 libraries and tablets for teachers. Many say it's again the way AAB talks about it. It's more of a wave and propaganda and nothing's happening on the ground. What do you have to say about it?
You see, when I became the minister, I'm the one who goes to school, one or two schools every day. You also saw that I went to three schools yesterday. So I have visited almost all the schools, maybe almost all the schools in Delhi. When I went to first of the school, I found that was a problem area in Northeast. I found 174 students living in one classroom, which was constructed to have 50 only. So even God becomes a teacher, he can't teach it. So I said, forget about content, quality, give infrastructure first. So in first year of my tenure, I worked on infrastructure only. though I started initiatives on training and content also, but my focus was infrastructure. We parked a lot of money. 25% of the budget is parked for education only. So most of the money, whatever cushion money we were having, is being used for infrastructure. So now that has taken off well. It's happening now. Then we focused on quality teacher training. As I said, we are sending them abroad, we are sending them at national expose. That's not part of that. We have to have facilities for education, we have to have facilities for teacher trainings, and then talk about education. We can't talk about education without having classrooms, without having teachers trainings. Now we can talk, and now we are touching that focus. What are you teaching? Why are you teaching? What are you learning? Why are you learning? Are the basic questions of education. What's your plan? What is your outcome plan from it? I normally define this output and outcome. Output is you read Kabir and you understand the meanings of the word that Kabir has used in his poems, and then you rewrite that in your exam and you pass that exam. This is the output. But do you understand what Kabir means? Have you absorbed anything into your own life? Have you learned to live what Kabir says, the way? Have you started living that? That's the outcome. Education is, whenever we call successful education, is successful on output only. It's not successful on outcome. I want to make education successful on outcome. It will take time, but that's the only goal of education.
Yeah, I mean, I want to know, how serious was Delhi government when they said they will take over private schools? Because you were against DPS, MET and all these big players around there.
Yeah, we are serious about it, and we have, whatever we do with quite an own understanding. We know what we are doing. You see, I have nothing against private schools. Many of the schools are delivering very good education at a time when government schools have almost failed, and they have been doing this last many years. So I'm grateful to them, but my grudges against them is that I have been asking them for last 2 years two things: make your admission system transparent, make your fee system transparent. Whatever you want to charge from the kid, I don't mind, charge it, but charge only what you're spending. Don't charge extra. Don't charge to spread your empire of education system or your brand. Charge them whatever you are paying, whatever you are spending on education in your own school. Charge that. You can charge for your French teachers you are getting from France. You can charge that from a student. It's up to the parent. They want to use that school or not for their child, for their children. It's up to the parents. But if you are spending less and charging more and siphoning off the money, then I'm behind you. I won't let you do that. That's happening in these cases. When Congress was ruling, there was a lot of corruption, and Congress ruled, I mean, even BJP also, they always support this privatization of schools, and they always support this business of schools. I don't support. Indian education system is based on trust. Even if private, you don't have a company which runs schools in India. You have trusts, which means it's a charity job. So you have to understand that spirit. So when I decided to issue notices to these 449 private schools, all of them are sitting on the money that they charged during Congress regime. They have to remember this is AAP regime now. They have to remember this money have to be refunded. Now, since court is directing, nobody can save you. So I'm happy that many of the schools are actually working at grassroots and they are refunding the money. They have started refunding the money. I'm getting lots of feedback from across the society.
Your mega PTMs is a lot of buzz, you know, it's creating a lot of buzz. It's looked as a reform. What is in it for you? You know, if we look at modernization, politicians typically have, okay, they have a percentage in getting computers, getting tablets, getting something. So mega PTMs, I don't see any personal gain for you in that. What is
I'm a part of the society and I see lots of personal gain in it. My society improves a lot when I do this. I belong to a society, and these students, these teachers are from that same society. They evolve. When society evolve, it's personal gain for me. Let me underline that. However, I mean, as an education reformist, I can say that there was hardly any dialogue between government teachers and parents of the government schools. they were like, there was a deadlock. When I used to go to public, public used to say, sahab, teacher to bahut hi bakwas hai sahab, padhate hi nahi hai sahab, padhana nahi aata sahab. Output samne dikh raha hai. Bacche ko apne textbook padhna nahi aata. So, partly they were right. When I used to go to teachers, they used to say, sir, parents to puchhiye mat sir, inko to ghar mein mahol hi nahi rakhte sahab, ghar mein ladai jhagde ka mahol hai, bachcha kaise padhega sir, hum kitni der padhayenge sir. So, I thought both of them need to talk actually with each other. They should start respecting each other. So, I initiated this 2 years back. In first meeting, this was, I'll show you one example. When I went to one of the classrooms, like I was going yesterday also, I usually go and sit in the classroom, listen what's the conversation going on. Many times talk to try to talk to teacher or parent. So one conversation which I heard in first of Mega PTM that was organized in Delhi 2 years back, 1.5 years back, was this lady teacher was listening to the parent carefully. I observed. She realized that I was there. So she stood up and started crying. This was a young lady teacher. I said, what happened, beta? She said, sir, aaj aapne humari aankhe khol di. Why? Because, sir, abhi main jis parent se baat kar rahi thi, I used to think ki they are nalayak. Ye apne bachon ka dhyan nahi rakhte hain, inhone bachche paida kar diye aur humare upar chhod diye hain. Aur ab humko padhane pad rahe hain. She said in these many words. Boli, sir, lekin aaj, aur bilkul padhai vidhai pe dhyan nahi rakhte hain, bahut hi nalayak family hai. Aur pata nahi kyun padha rahe hain hum inko. But now when I met him and I discussed with this father for 5 minutes, I found how wrong I was. I was such an stupid. She used this word. Now what happened? बोली ये आदमी सुबह 5 बजे उठता है, अपने घर से कपड़ा लेके जाता है, लोगों की कार साफ करता है, वहाँ से पैसे कमाता है और फिर सुबह 8 बजे एक रेडी लेके सब्जी बेचने निकल जाता है. How can I expect this person to be more careful to his kids? It's me who have to be. It's my duty. I'm getting salary for that. I also felt it was very touching moment for me also that this is the output. So I'm happy that this is happening. On the other hand, yesterday also I've shown a video of a very, I think class 10 or maybe class 12 kid, where this girl was telling me, I asked them that what was the benefit of parent-teacher meeting that you noticed in your own life. And this girl stood up in an assembly and she said, look sir, my parents used to think that, okay, I'm a girl and I'll just do some study and some home. I mean, I'll assist my mother in kitchen and all because I have to get married. And girls are for that. But now when in a PTM, my teacher told me that I'm a bright student, my mother has started thinking that I should pay more attention on my studies. Now she doesn't force me to work for home issues and all. She has noticed that, the teacher has noticed that. So these are very few instances, but I believe almost 10 lakh, I'm having 12 lakh parents, but 90%, 85%, 96% somewhere come. So almost 10 to 11 lakh parents coming to school, or maybe if they are coming with mother and father both, so maybe 20 lakh people or 15 lakh people coming in a day to school, meeting teachers, it's a wonderful event. And it's touching the nerves of the society.
But the success you had in IITs and even the board exams, the government school outperformed the private schools. How was it possible?
It was possible because of teachers' training, I believe. Because last year I spent a lot of my attention on, focus on this teacher's training. And that's why 372 students got through this IIT JEE exam. Then lot of students are cracking other examinations also. They have got good results in good percentage, and now they have got secured very good spaces in Delhi University, good colleges. So this is happening because of teachers' training. It's transforming the education system.
On one hand, you are talking of Delhi's education dream, and if you look at the way central government, or as mentioned, this few states of BJP rule thing, and they're on completely different tangent. They want to rewrite history and change the education system for their own benefits. Where do you think the country will ultimately...
You see, education in our country have to be scientific. It should be free from any ism, rightism, leftism, centrism. It should not be victim of any ism. It's a crime to evolve education through any ism, whether rightism or leftism or whatever. It should be scientific. I'm a big fan of Dr. Kalam here. He has given us a dream for that. Let's have our education twofold. One is to live with a skill, that's certificate one. enough, you have completed your education, this is your certificate, go and live. Second is to go for further learning, go for higher education, go for research and all this. So that's second certificate. And that also have to be scientific. That's why I said in the beginning, if you are learning Gita in Sanskrit or in any other thing, you should know what Gita means. And any person who has done PhD in Gita, any person who have done PhD in Ramayana or Ramcharitmanas should be equipped enough to show this in his own life rather than preaching others on it. Right now, whoever has done any study on Gita or Ramayana or Quran or something is capable enough of preaching for others. But they are not following it in their own life. Education should make sure that whatever is being taught, first of all, the person who is studying have to follow it in its own life. Then only we can achieve that. And that is my ism, you can say.
So do you think what all plans do you have now will be finished before your term finishes?
Many of them. Because this is my third year and I have started evolution in my examination system. This year, right now, we are going to start next week only this SA1 for my schools, and we have transformed the examination system. Though everything must have not been changed, but there are significant changes if you compare them vis-a-vis last year papers. This year examination paper are going to be different, definitely outcome oriented, not output oriented.